I was born in Henderson County, Kentucky, which is about 90 miles from Fort Campbell. My mother got killed when I was 5 years old, so I moved out on a farm with my grandparents. And when I was about 9 years old, my uncle took me down to Fort Campbell, Kentucky. And we went out on a drop zone and watched a parachute drop. And at the age of 9 years old, I looked up and I seen those boys coming out of those airplanes, and I said, that's me. And so at that point, I knew what my life was going to be like.
Gary Littrell joined the Army at the age of 17 with a contract to attend airborne school. He received further training at the U.S. Army Ranger School, where he also became an instructor. In April 1970, Littrell was one of four American advisors assisting the South Vietnamese Army's 23rd Battalion in Kontum Province.
I was an advisor to the 23rd Vietnamese Ranger Battalion, consisted of 143 Vietnamese Rangers, and they were absolutely warriors to the end. Most of them were grudge fighters. They'd lost their wife, their kids, their mothers, their fathers, and they, depending on their religion, most of them believed if they died honorably, they'd come back a better person, and so they weren't afraid of death. Me, I didn't believe that. I didn't want to get killed. I didn't want to be reborn the next day a better person. I wanted to stay the person I was. I kind of liked me. And we were moving towards the Cambodian border to find the enemy, identify their location, back off, and call in airstrikes on them. And we moved up on top of this one hill to spend the night, and we were surrounded. Surrounded by the 29th NVA Regiment and the 66th NVA Regiment and the K-6 Sapper Battalion, which consisted of about 5,000 of the North Vietnamese finest. And so it was a 24-hour, four-day fight. It first started with an artillery barrage, and which killed one of the lieutenants, filled the other and liver full of shrapnel and busted the eardrums of the third sergeant, so I was the only American left after I evacuated those three. Didn't seem like anyone else wanted to come in and help me. As an American advisor, if you didn't have an American voice on that radio, you got zero American support. You couldn't get any fast movers, you couldn't get any air support at all. And so my main job was to coordinate airstrikes, was use that radio and get us ammunition in by helicopter, evacuate the wounded that we could. They finally gave up because the fighting was so heavy they didn't want to come in and evacuate anyone else. Tried to make two or three runs and drop some ammunition. They did make some high speed low runs and kick some ammunition out to us, but they couldn't land. And so my primary job was just command and control, trying to get the Vietnamese to stand and fight.
Littrell continued to support the embattled battalion, struggling night and day to direct airstrikes and mark enemy positions, all the while encouraging the SVA fighters to hold on.
On the fourth night, I pretty much had come to the conclusion that I was dead, that it was over. A very quiet, peaceful, tranquil feeling come over. My God and I have our own thing going. We understand each other. And that night I knew that I would probably never see the sunshine. Thank God he didn't take me. He left me here for a reason. I'm not sure I found that reason yet, but there's a reason that I'm here.
4 days later, Littrell and only 41 walking wounded made it down the hill, but the enemy had been nearly wiped out.
Well, 3 years passed, I heard nothing. And I said, well, you know, I'm sorry, rascals. You know, I'm up there getting my butt kicked and everybody back in the rear is getting bronze stars and silver stars for little you know, getting in a 2-3 hour scrap, and here I've been up here for 4 days and four nights. Everybody got annihilated, and I got forgotten about. You know, and I be honest with you, a little upset. And about 3.5 years went by, and I got a call from the Commanding General of the 101st Airborne Division, which I worked in G3, and back then I was a little wild and would pull some crazy things every now and then. And I heard that the Commanding General wanted to talk to me. First thing went through my mind, oh my God, what the hell do I do now? So I went down, you know, I knew him. I'd been on that red carpet a time or two. And I walked in, you know, and reported to him, Sergeant First Class Littrell reports. Come over and sit down on the couch. I want to talk to you. I said, boy, I must have really screwed up. I said, he gonna take me over, set me down on the couch. Most of the time he just stands me at attention, chews my butt, and tells me to get the hell out of his office. But we went over and sat down on the couch, and it was General Sidney B. Berry, well, my idol. And he said, we made some small talk, and I'm waiting for him to tell me why he called me in there to chew my butt. And he finally said, well, I want you to know that we just got word from the White House that President Nixon wants you to join him in the White House on the 15th of October, so you can be presented the Medal of Honor. The ceremony was quick. See, my presentation was by President Nixon, and I was right in the middle of Watergate, between Watergate and goodbye. And in between Watergate and goodbye, things was interesting in the White House. And so I was there, it was hot and heavy. He come in, put the medal around my neck, shook my hand real quick and moved on. He had bigger fish to fry that day than me. But we spent 5 days there, and it was wonderful, getting some nice sightseeing, and it was an enjoyable trip. When I come back from Vietnam, we were dirty, filthy, rotten dogs. That's the way society viewed us. I refused to talk about Vietnam. I think my boys seen my reaction when people would ask me about Vietnam. And I think they thought it was probably a safe bet not to ever. But one of these days, I would like for my sons to come up and say, Dad, tell me what you've done in Vietnam. When I think about the Medal of Honor, I realize that I'm wearing this medal for the 400 and some people that died in those 4 days. I'm their representative. They won this medal. I was selected to wear it for them.